when I say check, check, check. Yeah. I'm here. I'm good. Invariably do I play out my theme song, you know, up to the point. But you almost figure out I was doing something. Hey, everybody, how are you? Let's take it from the top, shall we? Hello, everyone. How are you? 90 minutes after 6. Station. 6 p.m. That is. Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is the show called Inside the Zone. I was here on Monday and I'm here today again, and I'm so looking forward to being here with you. Man, I just love the feel that my voice is reaching far and wide. And that you're spending the time to be with me this evening. That's what I'm talking about. WLNK, Linkage Radio 101.5 FM. This is a show called Inside the Zone. I'm your host, Lady D. It is center stage today. The platform where voices are heard and people connect. The show is brought to you by Country Kitchen Pelena. And they're smack in the middle of the BJ Shopping Center. I'm talking about good evening, everyone. One minutes after 6. 914-600-4228. 914-202-4934. The telephone lines to link me here in the Link Radio studio. Are you out? Are you about doing something? Just can't get a chance to, you know, sit in one place and say, okay, let me just listen to the show. So if it's your position right now, I'm inviting you to dial 712-422-8858 and catch me on the run. It's a beautiful day. It's overcast. In fact, I think I'm seeing raindrops there. Going on the outside. Take it easy out there, won't you? Hello to all the cabbies. Hey, my cabbie Mark, Miss Stanley, and Turner. All the moms who stayed home today. All the dads who went out to work. My seniors, you went to your center today, your senior center, wherever it is, you play dominoes and cards and bow and all. Man, the debate last. Did you watch the debate? What did you gather from the debate? Has it changed your mind? I don't know what you think. Minutes after 6. It's center stage today, but I will not be having a guest with the evening. However, the evening is going to be nice and light and just for you. I invite you to call me at time you like, and we can talk about yesterday's debate, what your feelings are, and I'm also going to be giving you some you know, brief headlines coming out of Jamaica. And also, I'm going to be having my featured artist segment this evening. I plan to feature Roman Virgo, so we'll all this when, oh Lord. Yes, and you know, to just have an easy evening. I did a lot of work today. I worked hard today, and truth be told, I really just, you know, want to take it easy this evening, knowing that the show must go on. Somebody would like to come in and, you know, moderate for me this evening, host the show for me. I wonder who would like to host the show for me this evening. Just random. You think you could do it? It's not very difficult, you know. Not very difficult after you get a hang of it. But before we get into all of that, we have to get our praise on. We have to lift our voices in praise. You didn't get a chance to have a moment with your Creator this morning, and you know, today, or at no time at all today did you get a chance. We were just running, and you know, I'm going to be allowing you that time to just sit back, relax, and just say, Lord, have mercy on me. So it's now time for our inspirational zone, brought to you by Church in Pelham Manor. They are in the middle of the BJ Shopping Center. Give them a call, 914-633-5000. Let's go.
You know, it's Elijah alongside Joseph Moyle.
As I would say, yeah.
Say what you gotta say.
Yeah.
He was foretold. Right, he stepped off his throne, made from heavenly gold. Come and dwell among men to play a vital role. Now to sacrifice his life to save my wretched soul. Mystic and mighty God of that time, very sudden. 9 months in the matrix, the womb of a virgin. So majestic, so powerful, and full of glory. Blessed be the only ghost, is another big story.
He was wounded.
Criminal, but yet them treat him like that. Pure saliva to his face, cause up on him they are spot. And then they separate his face, John up on it, they cast that. In his hands and in his feet, treating them drive through. Christ the Pharisees keep, cause they know not what I do. Lucifer convinced the people now to send Christ to his doom. Crucify him on the cross, then put him body in the tomb.
Chastise me.
That's Inspirational Zone right here on Linkage Radio 101.5 FM. The show is called Inside the Zone. That was the voice of Joseph Emmanuel. Joseph Emmanuel with He Was Wounded, featuring Elijah Cottrell. I love that one. Didn't you? I did. He's wounded for my sins. Hey, everybody. Welcome to the show. It's a beautiful Thursday. Again, no matter what's going on outside your home, are you? You're driving on the line 95 somewhere. You're shopping. You are saying, tomorrow's going to be Friday. I can't look. Wait, rather. For the weekend to come. You know, a lot of people just live for the weekend. They got places to go, people to see, things to do. Right? And hey, Rose. And so I want to say good evening and welcome to you. As I said, it's going to be a nice but easy Thursday evening here on Center Stage with yours truly, Lady D. Are you celebrating your birthday today? If it's your birthday, I'd like to wish you a happy birthday. You were born. It was just a glorious day when you came into the world. As a matter of fact, I know three people who celebrated birthdays yesterday. My aunt, Auntie Joy in Jamaica, my very good friend Anne Marie, she lives up in Poughkeepsie, and another friend of mine, Dale. Three persons I know born on October 19th. And my cousin Nikki, she celebrated hers on the 18th. So birthdays all around. All the people who were born in the month of October, happy birthday to you. It is your wedding anniversary today. Who is celebrating their wedding anniversary? Or you know someone who is celebrating their anniversary? I'd like you to let them know that they ought to just hug each other. Go out, do something. If you're deciding that you're going to stay home this evening to celebrate your birthday, then do it in style. Have some hot chocolate or some hot cocoa, right? How about that? Yes. So welcome once again, 6:31 p.m. And I'm going to be switching gears right now because, as you know, customarily, I would have had the segment that I call Community Link. Regrettably, my guest wasn't able to make it this evening, and so I'm just going to be taking you to Jamaica with some headlines, and you're going to cap on, you know, what's going on live. How about that? 6:31 p.m. Linkage Radio 101.5 FM. Good evening, everyone. We are blessed, and I am feeling so many things have been happening. We're also going to be talking a little bit about Donald Trump. And DL, what did you think about the debate? I was posting my little one-liners on Facebook the moment I heard something that intrigued me. I posted, you know, and stuff like that, because I watched, I observed both candidates. I realized that they really don't like each other. Well, that's my opinion, that is. I don't think they really have a liking for each other. And but, you know, they are vying for this great, great title and called the presidency, the president, to be the president of the United States of America. And I don't know if one of them really knows what they're getting into, especially one of them. But the other one has had experience being, you know, first lady and all. So, former first lady. So, I'm only saying that you, I hope, if you are eligible to vote, I've been saying it to you, do not just stay home and not go out and exercise your right to vote. Because somebody's going to win and somebody's going to lose. And you don't want to know that if you did not cast your vote, then they said, oh, but we only lost by one and it's yours. Can you imagine that? That would not be a good thing. So, you know, the fact that the world was glued in to this debate yesterday, and more so today, Donald Trump was out, you know, saying how much... You only can laugh sometimes when you hear Mr. Trump speak. With all due respect, you know, I smiled at intervals today. Walking, saying, you know, he declared would be accepting whatever polls say if he only if he wins. Yes, Donald, keep it moving. Okay, so once again, it's Linkage Radio 1.5 FM, 914-600-4228, FM Radio 105.7 in the Bronx. They'll be joining me at 7 p.m. So right now, I'm going to take you to Community Link, and then after that, we will just talk, and I'll be featuring Romaine Virgo this evening as my featured artist. Welcome to the segment, ladies and gentlemen. It's me. Who am I? It's yours truly. Who am I? My name is Lady D.
Hi there, I'm Adrian Atkinson. Thank you for joining us for another edition of Jamaica Magazine. Today we'll be inviting you to join an education revolution. Also, when last have you done a check? What about a pap smear, ladies? You'll learn more about that and its link with cervical cancer. Stay tuned.
Heritage Competition is back. Enter your essay, poster, or photo and win big prizes. If age 9 to 12 years, enter the essay competition and tell us who is your favorite Jamaican sportsman or sportswoman and why. High school student, enter the poster competition. This year's theme is Jamaica's rich sporting heritage. If you're a tertiary level student, enter the photo competition. This year's theme is I am a sport champion. Competition closes for all three categories on November 6. Get started now. For information on submission and competition guidelines, visit our website at jis.gov.jm. Call 926-339024, extension 2137, or send an email.
Hey, I'm Lorraine Mendez, and this is your JIS News for Wednesday, October 19. Tourism Minister Edmund Bartlett says stakeholders are close to signing off on all the paperwork and permit for an investment to significantly add to tourism's room stock.
Yesterday, I negotiated 750 new rooms for Trelawney.
Minister Bartlett was speaking at this day's reception for the 2016 Rio Olympic and Paralympic athletes held at the Trelawney. Perception that this year's winter tourist season was on pace to be the best on record.
2,300 new rooms are coming on board for this winter. And all the US, the UK, and Canada, and all our markets are pacing ahead by over 5% of last year.
Government will be spending $30 million on a three-year program to furnish schools with stretchers and other medical equipment as part of emergency plans at the institutions. Education Minister Senator Royal Reed says the Health Safety Initiative will begin this financial year.
The government is committing for the next 3 years $10 million per year towards safety devices for such a program in Jamaica in collaboration with the
Minister Reed says the details of the program will be worked out with school principals and representatives of Inter-Secondary Schools Sports Association. He was addressing a presentation ceremony at Jampro on Friday. At that function, Team Jamaica Bickle presented 15 automated external defibrillators, AEDs, to schools across the island. The AEDs are portable electronic devices that diagnose life-threatening issues and are designed to be used by elderly persons. Receiving schools were trained to use the machines by experts attached to the diaspora healthcare sector. Team Bickle has also partnered with the Jamaica Association of Emergency Medical Technicians based at the University of the West Indies to provide ongoing training and support to the recipient schools. The Southern Regional Health Authority has boosted its ambulance fleets in Clarendon and Manchester by converting two 2017 Toyota Hiace buses to serve the purpose. Regional Director at the Health Authority, Michael Bent, says $14.4 million was spent on purchasing and converting the buses into ambulances resulting in about $7.6 million in savings.
And in addition, we have shortened delivery time from 6 months to 2 months.
He said the international specifications require ambulances were not common in the process and no procurement guidelines were breached, pointing out that the project was funded with fees collected through patients' health insurance card. The regional director says that method of payment should be viewed as a way to assist public health care facilities achieve their development goals.
We are not asking users to give us cash because there's no user fee. I'm imploring you to give your health cards, because once we have these fees, we can do much more.
One of the new ambulances was assigned to the Nell Town Hospital in Clarendon and the other to the Mandeville Regional Hospital. The Southern Regional Health Authority is responsible for all of the healthcare facilities within Manchester, Clarendon, and St. Elizabeth. Still on health, the Maypen Hospital is in a position to offer better treatment to heart attack and stroke patients following the recent receipt of a cardiac monitor. The equipment, valued at over $700,000, was donated by the Jamaican Canadian Association Nurses, JCAN.
We here at Maypen were committed to providing the best possible care for our patients. And with the help of JCAN, our ability to meet this commitment has been greatly increased.
It will be placed in the room of the hospital's high dependency unit to enable the effective management of heart attack and stroke patients post-operatively. And finally, government's call for Jamaicans to support the Help Haiti initiative in the wake of Hurricane Matthew is being heeded by at least one state agency and its private sector partners. Staff of JAMPRO recently collected supplies which have been taken to Food Corps for shipment to Haiti. The initiative, which was supported by exporters who do business with JAMPRO, included donations of syrups, juices, canned peas, pasta, bleach, and soaps. Minister of Education, Youth and Information, Senator Ruel Ridu, was on hand to assist with loading the items, urged more Jamaicans to support the Haiti relief effort. Jamaicans wishing to assist Haiti can do so in cash or kind. Cash donations may be deposited to NCB Kingston account 212-387-304. Donations of bottled water, tarpaulins, canned food, and other supplies should be dropped off at the Office of Disaster Preparedness and Emergency Management on Haining Road in Kingston. And that's it for Dice News today. I'm Lorraine Mendez. Thanks for watching.
Life is all about making decisions. Choosing from a number of options to do a particular thing, which may result in a specific outcome.
It can be difficult, but there are four things you can do to help make that decision.
Stop. Check out what's happening and remind yourself to think before acting.
Think.
Make sure you're aware of the choices, all the advantages and disadvantages. Then think about the consequences.
Act.
Choose the best option and do something about it.
Review.
Finally, review what you have done and determine if it was good or bad. That way, you'll be in a better position to make the next decision, whether big or simple.
The JN Foundation is leading a revolution in education with their recently held School Leadership Summit. They brought together former educators and motivational speakers to inspire change in our education system. Listen up.
Do you know what it means to have a revolution?
The revolution will make the impossible possible, to shape dreams through teamwork. This revolution.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the segment will resume shortly, but I hope you have been enjoying the features so far. As I mentioned to you earlier, it's really just my easy evening this evening. I did quite a bit today, so I just wanted to take a little, you know, time to provide you with information and all of that. So stay with me. Don't go anywhere, and the segment will resume shortly. Let's see. And once again, it's Linkage Radio 115 FM. Okay. So the segment will be a few minutes, but I've been chatting here on Facebook Live.
Life is all about making decisions, choosing from a number of options to do a particular thing, which may result in a specific outcome.
It can be difficult for things you can do to help make that decision.
Stop.
Check out what's happening and remind yourself. Think before acting.
Think. Make sure you're aware of the choices, all the advantages and disadvantages. Then think about the consequences.
Act.
Choose the best option and do something about it.
Review.
Finally, review what you have done and determine if it was good or bad. That way, you'll be in a better position to make the next decision, whether big or simple.
The JN Foundation is leading a revolution in education. With their recently held JN School Leadership Summit, they brought together transformative educators and motivational speakers to inspire change in our education system. Listen up.
Do you know what it means to have revolution?
The revolution will make the impossible possible. We'll share dreams through teamwork. This revolution will innovate, impact, lead. The revolution, however, will not be televised. This revolution is being spearheaded by the Jamaican National Building Society Foundation through the iLead School Leadership Project. The project seeks to create a transformation in an education process where schools and communities are inspired to reshape and redefine each child's learning experience. The summit held in July 2016 brought together those who have made the commitment to be change makers.
Our children cannot wait any longer. Our research clearly tells us that great schools are those which have great leadership. And at this point in our education, we need leaders who are bold, who are not afraid of doing what is uncomfortable, who are not afraid to innovate.
The school leader has that responsibility to implement and to seek out new techniques to encourage learning in the schools and learning within the settings of the schools. Because it's not okay to say that all schools will perform the same. And part of the experience is the development of this creative mind in education.
The Prime Minister reiterated the government's commitment to creating a world-leading education system.
Programs like the iLead project will help to ensure that we get maximum value for the money that we're spending. Because at the end of the day, above everything else that the government can do, education will only maximize the true benefit to the society when we have good institutional leaders at the school level.
Change is the expected outcome. But to get there, the change makers were encouraged not to waver from their mission.
They need to know that there will be resistance, but that persistence overcomes resistance. That if we, that's what a revolution excites inside of us, is that it forces us to become persistent. It forces us to say that we are strong enough and to believe that we can fight battles.
While leaders create the environment for change, they also need to challenge their students to maximize the possibilities in all opportunities.
As leaders in our school, we must make sure that our children are experiencing two things every day, rigor and joy. That those children are being challenged at the highest levels, but they love it so much that they look forward to coming to school every day. That our mission Our mission here around the world has to be to build schools that our children, that our parents, that our teachers are fighting to get into every day instead of fighting to get out of.
The revolution starts when we recognize the need for change while simultaneously cultivating the attitude to drive and accept the change.
You cannot take an individual or an institution to a point to which you have been. To put that in a theological context, the spirit of the leader is often the spirit of the institution.
It's a question of commitment. We need to be so committed and so involved that we can help. We bleed it. It oozes out of our every pores. We want and we desire and we need improvement so badly we can't help it. It hurts. We need to be in that place.
And to get to that place, it is imperative that the change makers keep the big picture in mind.
That's why it's so important that we reach them, those high expectations and that rigor, and challenge them early so they can see that they have 100% potential. They will rise to out of expectations. That's why we have to have high expectations for teachers.
Will come your way, but the hotter the battle you see.
Truth of the matter is, folks, is an innate, deep, almost inexpressible yearning which one of us to find our voice in life. It is in this place that we are able to dream big, 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 big dreams and turn up the volume on this. So over communicate the vision. Every opportunity you get, every staff meeting you have, every devotion you have, go back to that big vision of what this can come.
The change makers were reminded that the opportunity to weave magic was in their hands, and the creative outcome might not necessarily come from a wand.
You can get it if you really want. You can get it.
Next up, the second law of situation and summation force equals mass times acceleration. That's the second law Newton foresaw. If you want more, then the third law is in store. You have to hold within yourself the ideals and vision of what it is that you want to accomplish, and be willing and comfortable with saying the path to getting there might not be the conventional path. And then we have the idea of revolutionary practice and shifting things against the authority. Now, who is the authority in your school? You. The principal. Therefore, to truly do revolutionary work, what do you have to do? You're going to have to revolt against the current authorities. You're going to have to revolt against your... We're looking at revolution like it's an outside act. So, you have to work reprogramming yourself.
You can be a voice in the revolution. You can be the change makers by making a commitment to stand in the gap for all children and help support their dreams until they can stand alone. You can help them create that thing that will make this world awesome. Join the revolution at a school near you.
See here, sir, when I call your name, roll call, roll call. Holness.
Yes, sir.
Jarrett.
Yes, sir.
Reed.
Yes, sir.
Rattray.
Yes,
Phillips.
Yes, sir.
Brown.
Yes, sir.
Are you in the revolution race?
Are you in the revolution race?
Join in the revolution.
A and Foundation.
Join in the revolution.
Join in the revolution.
With J and Foundation.
Here
we go. Revolution. 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 Right now.
Do you know what it means to have a revolution? And what it takes to make...
We have championed e-learning in Jamaica, provided state-of-the-art technology in over 200 educational institutions, developed materials for CSEC, piloted the Tablets in Schools project in 38 schools, including infant and primary, and trained thousands of teachers in technology integration. We are Learning in Jamaica Company Limited, ELJAM, an agency of the Ministry of Science, Energy and Technology. Visit our website, www.elearnja.org.
How much do you know about cervical cancer? Do you know that a simple, inexpensive procedure can help in the fight against this type of cancer? Find out more in this next feature.
It's an awful multiplication of cells out of the normal that take over your system rather than the normal cells.
According to the Ministry of Health, in 2010, 3,198 persons died of cancer, accounting for 24% of all deaths in Jamaica. The common types found in women are cancers of the breast, cervix, and colon. On the other hand, cancer of the prostate, lung, and stomach are more common in men. The good news is doctors say that these illnesses are largely avoidable. And the doctors say prevention and early detection are our best defense, even while the level of treatment and care is improving. In addition to promoting healthy lifestyle, government and its private sector partners are revolutionizing the gamut of care, with two linear accelerator machines purchased to provide timely and efficient access to cancer care treatment. Our most vulnerable patients are targeted to have access at no cost at centers of excellence being established at the St. Joseph's Hospital and the Cornwall Regional Hospital.
Changes in standard of living, introduction of screening methods and public health education and promotion have impacted the distribution of cancer seen in Jamaica over the years. This trend is expected to continue, at least in the short term, as public health education increases and screening becomes more widespread.
In the case of cervical cancer, caused by a viral infection from the human papillomavirus HPV, the Pap smear is considered the best screening method to date.
And the reason for this is that a screening method should be able to find a disease before it has become established, find it in the precancerous phase, be easily accessible, not very invasive, inexpensive, and universally available. The Pap smear satisfies all that sort of criteria.
The Pap smear is not an actual test for cancer, but rather a test to detect the presence of any abnormal cells with the potential to develop into cancer. The result from this painless process is used to inform decisions about what treatment to apply to prevent cancer from developing.
A sample.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the segment is almost finished, as a matter of fact. So I will resume in seconds. I'm not sure why we're having a breakdown, but welcome everyone. I hope you're being informed, courtesy of the JIS, Jamaica Information Service in Jamaica. And to the few who are on Facebook Live, good evening, Monica. How are you?
Oh, hi.
Yes. So once again, welcome, and I will be taking you back to the segment. And we'll be wrapping up in a few minutes. We were on the segment about cervical cancer, I believe it is.
And promotion have impacted the distribution of cancer seen in Jamaica over the years. This trend is expected to continue, at least in the short term, as public health education increases and screening becomes more widespread.
In the case of cervical cancer, caused by a viral infection from the human papillomavirus HPV, the Pap smear is considered the best screening method to date.
And the reason for this is that a screening method should be able to find a disease before it has become established, find it in the precancerous phase, be easily accessible, not very invasive, inexpensive, and universally available. The Pap smear satisfies all of that sort of criteria.
The Pap smear is not an actual test for cancer, but rather a test to detect the presence of any abnormal cells with the potential to develop into cancer. The result from this painless process is used to inform decisions about what treatment to apply to prevent cancer from developing.
A sample of cells is taken, sometimes even a little brush, There's no creeping and clip on all of that, like what's the perceptions out in the street.
Squamous cells, which are cells lining outer layers in areas such as the lung, hand middle, mouth, vagina, and cervix, are usually affected by the human papilloma virus. The virus gets to the cervix during intercourse and has the ability to transform the normal cells into precancerous ones.
You hardly ever get cervical cancer in women who have never had sex. From getting the virus to getting cervical cancer can take 15 years or so.
The recommendation for annual screening to detect, monitor, and treat with any incidence or progression that might be taking place.
The next reason for annual check is that there's no test that is 100%. You know, all tests have false positive and false negative. You do a smear and it's normal, but something is there. If you keep doing it, it will pick up something.
Abnormal smears can be treated in the precancerous stage by methods that include freezing, cauterization using electricity, and what is called the loop. That is, removing the area and having what is called a cone to abort the process. Where cancer has developed, treatment will involve radiotherapy and chemotherapy, and possibly major surgery. In an aggressive move to reduce local cervical cancer cases, the government of Jamaica has taken a decision to introduce human papillomavirus HPV vaccines to protect against high-risk strains of this family of viruses. HPV vaccines are recommended for preteen girls and boys ages 11 to 12, providing immune protection from the virus before exposure.
We have two types. We have one that has called valent. It vaccinate against two types of HPV, 16 and 18. Are numbered, and there is one that is quadrivalent that vaccinates against 6, 11, 16, and 18. 6 and 11 vaccinate against genital warts, while 16 and 18 vaccinate against 70% of cervical cancer.
There is a new vaccine to be introduced that vaccinates against 9 types of HPVs. This has the potential to prevent 9% of cervical cancers.
We are going to do better when we have this cervical cancer HPV vaccines.
Take the necessary actions to stay healthy. Get screened yearly. Eat well. Exercise and get vaccinated.
And control the keys to a healthier heart. Know the numbers for your blood pressure, cholesterol level, blood, your weight, and body mass. Give yourself a fighting chance. Find out the risks they represent and what you need to do to stay healthy. Talk to your doctor and start making healthy lifestyle choices to prevent a heart attack or stroke.
How can you naturally control your weight, improve your food, increase your energy, and prevent diseases? By exercising, of course. If you need more reasons to get and move, check this out.
Keeps you young. Make you look good in your clothes. Make you attractive to sex.
It's only a matter of fitness and health. Keep me vigorous and keep my youth.
It's the healthy way. I want to say slim.
It is true that many of us know that exercise is good for us, but we avoid it. Why? Because we are afraid that exercise has to be vigorous before it can be effective. But medical trainers say this is not true. Every little bit counts. It all adds up to burning more calories. We may not be ready for a structured program like going to the gym, but we can start small.
The first thing that exercises help us to do is to maintain a healthy lifestyle. And the first thing that we want when we exercise is to live long. And so the longevity of life is in fact guaranteed for a person who lives a healthy lifestyle by exercise.
Medical experts say if we are not engaging in enough physical activities, we are at major risk for developing coronary artery disease. It can also contribute to other risk factors like obesity, high blood pressure, and diabetes. However, physical trainers say before we start a vigorous exercise program, there are a few things we must do.
You need to consult your physician first, get an okay from them, and then you proceed with your exercise. And we would advise you not to start vigorously. Start exercising at slow paces, gradually getting into the vigorous aspect of exercise.
According to physical trainers, we must do any moderate to vigorous aerobic activity for a minimum of at least 3 to 4 times per week. This is to reduce or eliminate some of the risks associated with a lack of physical activity as part of our regular routine.
Here we go.
Moderate physical activity may include brisk walking, gardening, raking, sweeping the floor, pacing while you talk, when you're on the phone, pace around. This is a great way to stay moving while doing something you enjoy. Getting up each hour to stretch or walk the stairs at work, and dancing can also make a difference.
You don't have to go to a gym to exercise. And exercise is
all right, so they say you don't have to go to the gym to exercise, but you can do your walk and so on. All right, we're going to wrap that up now, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you got as much information as you needed coming out of Jamaica, courtesy of JIS. Welcome once again. It's Inside the Zone, Radio 101.5 FM. And I want to say hi, everybody, those who are on Linkage Radio 101.5, those of you who are on Facebook Live, I want to say good evening, and those of you who are viewing via the World Wide Web, www.linkageradio.com, welcome to you. 914-600-228, 914-202-94. I'm exercising here. I'm good. I'm alive today. How about you? Let's get music on. It's now 7:00 p.m., 6 minutes after 7 o'clock.
Together, I will leave you and
Yes, we've got amazing love. Ooh, so amazing. And I've been waiting for a love like you. It's amazing to be loved. I'd follow you to the moon and the sky above.
About that. That's Luther Vandross's So Amazing. Got another selection of his 9 minutes after 7 o'clock. Welcome to Touch FM Radio 105.7 in the Bronx. It's an easy Thursday evening for me this evening. How about that? More music for you. More music, 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 music. Here we go.
I can say for certain that it's true. There's a chance for me and you. I really feel like the time is. The picture in my mind is very clear. I think love has brought us here. I remember now. Gonna get the chance to love. Wait for love, love.
long time.
Wait for love.
And you're gone. Since I lost my baby.
asleep late last night, and I dreamed that the night and almost half the day away. I just got up so I could hear her say,
welcome. How are you?
Good evening.
Yes, sir. Good evening.
What's happening? Is it Lulu Danzoff's birthday or is Sanderson Day?
Not at all. I just felt like playing his selections.
Oh, you're in a Lulu Danzoff state of mind.
Mm-hmm.
No talking.
No, I'm listening. I'm listening. You asked me a question. I gave you an answer.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
How's the talking today?
Nothing. I'm just writing out my evening this evening. Is there something you'd like to talk about?
Oh, I thought maybe you wanted to dabble in the fiasco.
You mean? I know. It's indeed a fiasco. Can you give me a few minutes then?
Can you call back our hold?
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
I fell asleep late last night.
Yes, Hassan, this is your request.
The night and almost half the day.
Link Radio 101.5 FM. The show is called Inside the Zone. It's center stage today, the platform where voices are heard and people connect.
She's still in love, and no one could take her love away. Ooh, love wakes me up every day, and I thought no one could ever make me feel this way. It fills me up every time I hear her say, she's still in love. So
someone you see who would only dream of me. She'd be in love just 'cause she'd wanna be. She'd wanna be loved. There's nothing better than love. What in the world could you ever be thinking of instead of our fault? So let yourself reach for.
And Gregory Hines, there's nothing better than love. That's a request by Hassan. Good evening, everyone. How are you? Welcome to the show, Inside the Zone. I'm your host, Lady D, and I am just riding it nice and easy on a beautiful Thursday right here in New York City. How are you? Those of you who are in Canada, those of you who are in Jamaica, those of you who are across the globe, I'd like to welcome you. Hi to my friends on Facebook Live. You know, there are some friends of mine who grew up singing in choir together, and I just asked my Facebook Live friends if they would like to request a song. Hassan requested a song. This is my friend Carly Lee, all the way in Canada, saying it's through the blood. Delivered June, delivered. Oh my God. Ah, anyway, 914-600-4228, 914-202-4934. For those of you who would like to call in on Skype line, that's 914-600-4228. Once again, 914-600-4228. And I have another selection for you right now. And this is, he's no longer with us. I tell you, the guys and the girls who have made their transition, they truly left a legacy. Patricia, you're so right. She enjoyed the brief segment with Luther Vandross simply because, you know, they were just such great artists, and we are so thankful that we can sit back, relax, and listen to their songs. It's as though they never left. You know, it's like they're not gone anywhere. How about that? Are you ready for some more? I am. Here we go.
Just a little bit more. It's so good.
Hi.
Oh, yes.
Hello.
I just wanted to thank you. My name is Hassan. And that was, like I said, that song normally takes my breath away. So I appreciate that. That was just outstanding.
Oh, you're
welcome. Now, you know, I'm going right back to the program. I'm so grateful that you listen. You know, you don't just sit back and record something and then expect the world to respond to it. You're live.
That's right. I'm live. That's right. I appreciate you calling me, Hassan.
For the aim of wish, I will be there.
All right.
But never, you got to love me in a special
way. All right.
Way.
Thank you. Take it easy.
Later.
Okay. Bye-bye.
That a lot of people don't
7:34 p.m.
Talking about a 50-50 love, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, 7:34 p.m. Once again, the show is brought to you by Country Kitchen Manor. They're smack in the middle of the shopping center. Give them a call, 914-633-5000. That's 914-633-5000. They got breakfast specials for you. They got the big country breakfast. They got 6 grain and granola pancake breakfast for you. They got English muffin breakfast, strawberry Belgian waffle. A whole lot going on over there. And their Caribbean flavors as well. Jerk chicken, jerk salmon, jerk chicken tenders, jerk shrimp and salmon combo, jerk steak. They also got their classic Caribbean entrees. Curry goat salmon, curry goat jumbo shrimp, curry goat shrimp and salmon combo, oxtail and beans, island stew chicken, curry chicken, yum, yum, yum. Give them a call, 914-633-5000, at once again, Country Kitchen Pelham Manor. They're smack in the middle of the BJ Shopping Center. This is Linkage Radio on a 1.5 FM. We bring you the best in roots, reggae, R&B, disco, gospel, calypso, and a host of other selections aired right here on your budding and buzzing station. More music for you. Here we go.
Insecure. And you came with your 16.
that's what it's all about. 7:39 p.m. The show is called Inside the Zone with Lady. Center stage today, the platform where voices are heard and people connect. I'd like to say hi to Dervin Malcolm. Hello, Dervin. So nice of you to be stopped by here this evening. Hi, Rosie. Hi, Clint. Hi, Chinna Spies. And all those who are listening to me this evening, I want to welcome you. It's Linkage Radio 101.5 FM right here in New York, 7:39 p.m. And if you'd like to give me a call, the telephone numbers are 914-600-4228, 914-202-4934. That's 914-600-4228, 914-202-4934. All right, I got more selections for you right now. Here we go. Welcome to the segment. The show at 8. I'd also like to welcome Touch FM Radio 105.7 in the Bronx. Yeah, I like it. The sound of Debaj, Debaj, Debaj. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome once again. It's a beautiful Thursday, 7:44 p.m. right here on Linkage Radio 101.5 FM. Wherever you are in the world, log on to www.linkageradio.com. That's www.linkageradio.com. You can also catch me on the run by dialing 712-432-8858. That's 712-432-6858. It is gonna be all right. I was just reading something. I apologize. I got distracted. All right. So for those of you who are listening on 1.5, good evening to you. Hey, to my cabbies out there and to the children. Parents, do you know where your children are at 7:45 p.m.? I hope you need more music for you. And an all time favorite of many people.
Oh, I'd give a lifetime of stability. Anything you wanna need. Nothing is impossible for you. There are no words or ways to show my love or all the thoughts I'm thinking of. Cause this life is no good.
Welcome to the show.
Good evening, Lady D. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm best.
Oh, my Arlene, you're home from work.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Just saying hi as usual.
As usual, I'm playing some songs just for you and Tafari.
Oh, that's lovely.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just relax in it and full joy.
You should. You don't want to miss the one that's on the turntable right now. I'd suggest you hurry off the line.
Okay, so let me hurry up and get up. You have a blessed one.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Bye. I'd just like to take this one from the top. How about that? Another request coming up. Clint asked me to play the song that was played at their wedding, Pat and himself. I'm going to be taking that up in a few with you, Clint, I promise. Kenny Lattimore for you. No, I would 10 to 8 o'clock time signal brought to you by Country Kitchen Pelham Manor. Give them a call, 914-633-5000.
Should leave, I die, and here's why.
Selection is especially for Pat and Clint. They celebrated their wedding anniversary on February 20th, I was told via the Facebook Live, and I promised them next year we'll do something nice. Eric Benet's Spend My Life With You.
I never knew such a day could come, and I never knew such a love could be inside of one. Never knew what my life was for, but now that you're here, I know for sure.
I never knew till I looked in your eyes. I wasn't complete till the day you walked into my life.
Each and every Thursday from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. right here on Linkage Radio 101.5 FM with Center Stage, the platform where voices are heard and people connect. I had a great time being here with you this evening, and I'm looking forward to being back here on Monday with the Monday Drive, keeping you in the know in the city you walk, drive, and reside. 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Check out the show, spread the word, let someone know this coming Monday. As always, I wish you a wonderful, wonderful weekend. I will not be here on Monday, God willing. And I am just going to say love yourselves, love your children. And remember everything you do. It's the will of God concerning your life. The show is brought to you by Country Kitchen Pelham Manor. And today's Seafood Thursday. Stop by Pelham Manor Plaza right there, smack in the middle of the BJ Shopping Center. Give them a call, 914-633-5000. Where are your children? Do you know where they are? I hope you do. Have yourselves a wonderful weekend, everybody. Love, love, blessings. As always, I'm out of here.